يا ويحهم ماذا جنوا وتأفكوا وأتوا بقول الجاهل الفتان ورأيت منهم أرعنا يدعو إلى سحر يحل به لدى الكهان.
الحمد لله واحد الديان مبتل كيد السحرة والمنجمين والكهان المخالفين لشريعة الخير الأنام وصلاة وسلام على سيدنا محمد. قال نبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اجتنبوا سبع الموبقات الشرك بالله والسحر. أما بعد أحبة في الله, there is no such thing as a lazy person. He is either sick or uninspired. Laziness is a very complex situation where only the individual who is suffering from this disease knows that what he's going through. There is a bigger percentage in the world people who are suffering with diseases where they medically cannot be treated. Example is laziness. Laziness can be caused by hasad. Laziness can be caused by evil eye. Laziness can be caused by shaitan. Laziness can be caused by magic, sihr. Now to name my subject here is the laziness which caused by sihr, which is called sihr al-khumul. A lot of youngsters suffer from this disease, a lot. You'll find an individual who is very inspired, who is motivated, who is poor and wants to go and look for a job. And once he finds a job, he straight away wants to quit. You'll find him sitting, wondering, very disturbed. When you ask him, he'll tell you, leave me alone. This is the work of sihr al-khumul. This is the work of magic, which leads to the individual to become like that. We ask Allah to protect us. This individual becomes weak. His situation deteriorates. He wants to do something, but there is nothing he can do. There is a force forcing him to become like that. A lot of women and young men have this problem of laziness, sihr al-khumul. This problem, a couple of weeks ago, I've read on an individual who is suffering from this, who just wants to sit unmotivated. The individual doesn't want to do anything, just wants to sit, just like a zombie. This is a disease, my beloved brothers and sisters out there. This type of magic have ways and why they do this. This type of magic is to make the individual failure totally. But there is nothing he can do for himself. This magic have signs and have motives. What are the motives? The motive is the envious person wants to destroy the individual either because of education, because of marriage, etc. And they either put it in your food or in your drink, or they take your clothes, your picture, or anything that belongs to you and represent it to the magician. And the magician does that job. And when he does the job, he sends the jinn to the person in one location alone. And the ulama have divided our head into three sects, the front, the back, and the middle. The middle, that's where the engine of the human being, the brain, everything that functions is there, the thinking and everything. So the shaitan magician sends the jinn in the middle of the head and he sits there, controls the individual fully, and he destroys him. And this magic and any other magic have signs. What are the signs? The signs are always the same when it comes to magic. Is day, night, and during the ibadah. The individual will struggle during the night to sleep. He will have dreams, or he will be in insomnia, unable to sleep. During the day, he will struggle as well. During the ibadah, he will struggle either praying salah or reading the Quran. He will struggle. This is to do with any other magic. Now, sihr al-khumul has got its signs, the black magic of laziness. If you have these signs, know that you've been hit by sihr al-khumul. Hate gathering, love to be alone, love to eat alone, love to be in isolation, laziness too much, hate to talk to anybody, hate to leave home, idleness in abundance, insomnia, mind wandering around, absent-minded, thinking a lot, permanent headache that it doesn't go. Now, how to treat this problem? This problem, the individual needs to acknowledge that he's got this problem and he needs to know that he needs help. Number one. Two, isti'ana ila Allah. Three, dua ila Allah. 4 salah, 5 times. 5 adhkar, morning, evening. 6 hijama in the middle of the head every month. 7 ruqya every month or every 2 months. And the individual let him do his own self ruqya. And read the 10 ayah in Surah Maryam and the 4 beginning of Surah Baqarah, the 4 ayah and the 3 ayah of Surah Baqarah in the end, and 5 ayahs of Surah Maryam at the beginning, and Ayatul Kursi and Qul A'udhu Birabbil Falaq and Qul Rabbi Nas, in abundant, in a water, and shower with that water, make henna from the water you've read on it, a little bit put in the henna, put 1 spoon of salt, mix it, make a thick paste, put it in your head. That you should do it every week, once a week, or every after 2 days. The henna will never change your color. It will never change the color of your hair if it's black. If it's white, yes, it will do that. So do not worry about the henna. Get the original henna, not fake. Just get the green original henna. Inshallah, Allah will help, inshallah, by the will of Allah, and make a lot of dua. وآخر دعوانا والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.